हेलो माय डियर चिल्ड्रन, माय सेल्फ योर इंग्लिश टीचर अर्पिता रॉय। होप सो यू ऑल आर फिट, फाइन एंड सेफ एट होम। वेलकम टू द सेकेंड टर्म ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। टुडे आई विल बी टीचिंग यू इंग्लिश लिटरेचर, दैट इज इंग्लिश टू। द नेम ऑफ द बुक इज फैंटासिया। आई विल टीच यू पिनोक्कियो From the Adventures of Pinocchio, Chapter Number 8, Page Number 62. This story is about a wood carver named Geppetto and a wooden puppet named Pinocchio. Geppetto was a poor wood carver who lived in Italy. He did not have a family. He was very lonely as he did not have a wife or children. Children, we have learned some new words, so let us know the meaning of those words. Woodcarver, a person who makes and designs beautiful wooden objects. Lonely, alone. Puppet, a doll or a toy that looks like a human being. One day, Geppetto found a piece of wood. He decided to carve a puppet from it. He made a puppet of a boy and named it Pinocchio. It looked like a real boy. He kissed the wooden boy on his cheeks. Soon, Pinocchio opened his eyes and jumped up. The wooden puppet got life. Geppetto was surprised when he saw Pinocchio open his eyes and jumped up. Pinocchio saw the door open and he ran out into the street. And soon Geppetto cried, "Catch him, catch him." In the street, Pinocchio bumped into a policeman and he said to the policeman that Geppetto was chasing him and he needs to help him. The policeman, on hearing this, arrested Geppetto and took him to the police station. Naughty Pinocchio returned home and sat in a chair near the fire. Soon, a fairy came to him and asked him to listen to his father, or he will be very sorry for not listening to his father. When the fairy vanished, Pinocchio fell asleep. Children, we have learnt now few more new words, and let's know the meaning of those words. Bumped, to hit someone. Street, road. Chasing, to run after someone. Fairy, a small imaginary person with magical powers. Vanished, disappeared. Geppetto came home and then he decided to send his son Pinocchio to school. But he was very poor, so to buy things for the school, he decided to sell his coat and buy books for him. So Pinocchio started going to school. But one day, instead of going to school, Pinocchio went to see a puppet show. The puppet asked Pinocchio to dance with them on the stage. Pinocchio joined them on the stage, and at the end of the show, the puppet master gave him 5 gold coins to give to his father. Pinocchio was very happy on getting the 5 gold coins. Suddenly, 2 thieves came and tried to steal the money he got. Pinocchio ran to the forest to save himself from the thieves, but he got lost in the forest. A fairy who always helped Pinocchio came and saved him and took him home. On the way to home, the fairy asked Pinocchio, "Did you go to school?" But Pinocchio lied to her that he went to school daily and he never went to a puppet show. The more he lied, the longer his nose grew. Pinocchio began to cry seeing his long nose. The fairy advised Pinocchio never to tell lies and always listen to his father. The fairy told Pinocchio If he lied, his nose would keep on growing longer. Also, he should always tell the truth and never tell a lie. Giving this advice, the fairy disappeared. Pinocchio went inside the house and hugged Geppetto. He repented for all his mistakes. He promised his father to be a good boy. Suddenly, Pinocchio was not a wooden toy anymore. His nose too became small and he became a real boy. Children, the meaning of hugged is put one's arm around another person's body to show love. Delighted means happy. Geppetto was very happy and delighted. His wish had come true. Pinocchio now always told the truth. The moral of the story is, a lie, no matter the size of it, is always a lie. We should always follow the virtues of honesty and speak the truth. Children, I have attached a PDF file which consists of all the exercises of this chapter. Thank you.